Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit. We may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Sarah saw the son of Hagar, the Egyptian, whom she had borne to Abraham, playing with her son Isaac. So she said to Abraham, "Cast out this slave woman with her son, for the son of this slave woman shall not inherit along with my son Isaac." The matter was very distressing to Abraham on account of his son. But God said to Abraham, "Do not be distressed because of the boy and because of your slave woman. Whatever Sarah says to you, do as she tells you, for it is through Isaac that offspring shall be named for you. As for the son of the slave woman, I will make a nation of him also, because he is your offspring." So Abraham rose early in the morning and took bread and a skin of water and gave it to Hagar, putting it on her shoulder, along with the child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered about in the wilderness of Beersheba. When the water in the skin was gone, she cast the child under one of the bushes. Then she went out and sat down opposite him a good way off, about the distance of a bowshot. For she said, "Do not let me look on the death of the child." And as she sat opposite him, she lifted up her voice and wept. And God heard the voice of the boy. And the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and said to her, "What troubles you, Hagar? Do not be afraid, for God has heard the voice of the boy where he is. Come, lift up the boy and hold him fast with your hand, for I will make a great nation of him." Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. She went and filled the skin with water and gave the boy a drink. God was with the boy, and he grew up. He lived in the wilderness. Lived in the wilderness of Paran, and his mother got a wife for him from the land of Egypt. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. By no means. How can we who have died to sin go on living in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in death like his, we certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you might also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Jesus said to the 12 apostles, A disciple is not above the teacher, nor a slave above the master. It is enough for the disciple to be like the teacher, and the slave like the master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more will they malign those of his household? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before others, I will also acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I also will deny before my Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to the earth. I have come to bring peace. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, and a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and one's foes will be members of one's own household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who find their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. I told you we were going on a bus ride today. Would you want to go?
No. Enough for the bus. Sorry.
The youth just got back from their trip to Canoga, and we had bus problems, I understand.
I apologize for that. I'm sorry. I know that there's not much we could have done about it, but I hope that your time there was fruitful and that you received some gifts from them.
About all of you, have any of you ever received a gift from someone that you did not know you needed? And then once you got it, you wondered, how did you ever manage to live without it? I received one of those gifts this week. I went up to Augusta, Georgia to witness with a friend, a fellow colleague, a priest, who was a classmate of mine in seminary and who took her first vows as a novice in a convent of St. Helena. And I went up there to witness and participate in these vows. And it was what I was really looking forward to was that ceremony, but also the drive up. I figured, you know me, time for a road trip, looking for a couple of days to get away. The entire trip up to Augusta, all I could think about was what I was going to do and where I was going to stop on the way back. I'm planning what I'm going to do
and not even thinking about what it was that I was going there to really meet him. And it was after being there for a half a day that I received the gift that I really needed. It was a wonderful, peaceful place. And it took me about 3 hours to figure out I needed to stay. And I did. I stayed until, I believe it was until Tuesday. It was a wonderful gift. It was completely unexpected, and I did not figure that that was part of the plan at all. Maybe Canoga was that for you, was like that for some of you a little bit. You got up there with anticipation. You've been there before. You knew what you thought you were going to do, and then maybe you got some surprises, and you maybe met some people that you didn't plan on meeting, or that you had some experiences that you had not planned on, and hopefully they were wonderful, great experiences. Life could be like that. We get these gifts. We get these absolutely wonderful gifts that we don't really realize that we need. And being able to share them was a wonderful experience for me. It was something that I needed at the time, to just be present. To be present there at that convent, and to be part of the rhythm of the convent life. It was a place where they answer the bells to go to prayer 5 times a day. And your day is set out by those bells. You hear the bell ring and you head over to the chapel, which was a beautiful place. And the entire convent sat on about 30 acres of wooded land up on a hill in Augusta. It was absolutely gorgeous. But after a day of being there, you start to enter into this rhythm of the life that they lead. And the opportunity to just stop what you're doing and to pray. It's amazing to me that the prime purpose of these women in this convent is simply to pray. That is their prime purpose in life. And they are praying for St. Mary Magdalene today. There are people gathered in prayer in a community that are doing nothing but praying. And in turn, we will offer our prayers to them this morning also. But it is a gift that we get from them, and we are able to learn, and we are able to move into. And it's something that we can really be thankful for. Especially this time of summer, as we get ready to have things change just a little bit. Maybe slow down just a little bit. There'll be some changes that take place. Some of you getting ready to leave for college. And hopefully you'll use this as an opportunity to get into some kind of rhythm that you can take with you when you get up to school and you start in a new place. Our gospel message is a lot like that today. We get this gospel message from Jesus talking about, really, about obedience and discipleship. It can be a very confusing message because we see in it that it sounds as if Jesus is saying, I'm trying to create havoc in your household, and that is not what he's saying at all. Saying that he has come to bring a sword, not peace. What Jesus is trying to tell us is that if you will put God first in your life and turn that over to God, then everything else will fall into place. The rest of the relationships that you have in your life will take care of themselves. Not that they don't need tending to, but that if you put God first, God will not forsake you and the other relationships that you have. It is when we decide that we want to do things our way and plan them first and set ourselves and decide to live by them that we get ourselves either in trouble or we find ourselves a little out of kilter with God. Jesus is trying to tell us, allow God to be first in your life, and in doing so, God will not allow impediments to get in your way in the other relationships that you have. Having the opportunity to be in a community where we can worship and pray together, where we can develop a rule of life that we can take with us when we go, is so very important. It helps us to understand obedience. And it's not just following rules, but establishing rules in your own life. Establishing a rule of life for yourselves that involves things like prayer and worship and reflection and study. You see, in this gospel message, Jesus is addressing his apostles as disciples. And there's a difference between the meaning of apostle and disciple, even though they are used interchangeably with the disciples. Apostle is someone who sends a message. It is a messenger. Jesus specifically is using the word disciple because it alludes to someone who learns, teaches. There's a difference. Jesus is getting ready to send his disciples out into the world to go and proclaim the good news of God in Jesus Christ. But before that takes place, Jesus is trying to get his disciples to recognize and to understand the importance of understanding what it is they were getting ready to do, to be disciples first and apostles second. It makes perfect sense. If you're going out to sell something, it might be a good idea if you know what it is you're going out to sell. It makes good sense for us to understand what it is our faith is teaching us. When we go out into the world and we try to explain to people who Jesus Christ is in our lives and how God can change our lives, it helps if we can understand and articulate our faith. That's what discipleship is about. It's about a lifelong journey. It's not just one class, one course, one retreat. It's a lifelong journey. And in setting forth this rule that I would love for you to help establish in your own life, so that you've got something you can ground yourself in and always return to, being able to understand that discipleship and learning is very important, not only for school, but in your own life. And it's not a one-shot deal, it's a lifetime journey. Being able to worship together in a community, to pray together, to reflect on what it is that God is trying to tell us, to try to reflect on where God is in our life and how we can best meet what God is asking us to do. It takes more than just reflection. It takes learning. As Episcopalians, we often take for granted that all we have to do is come to church on Sunday and we're let off the hook and nothing else matters. And nothing can be further from the truth. We owe it to ourselves, as Episcopalians, as children of God, as people who are on a journey trying to discover more and more about God, to take some time in our life to establish a rule for ourselves, and for part of that rule to include study. Studying what it is to be in a relationship with God. Understanding theology. Getting a greater grasp of who Jesus Christ is in our life. Worship is important. Prayer is important. Reflection is important. Study is important. This is exactly what Jesus is trying to tell his disciples this morning. Study is important. And then he reinforces that by the greatest words that we hear from Jesus, especially when we're getting ready to take on something that is new to us or feels a little bit different, or takes us out of our element. Jesus reminds us, Jesus proclaims to us, Jesus tells us, do not be afraid. Establish a rule for yourself. Establish a rule of life that you can live by. Worship, pray, reflect, study. Let us affirm our faith by saying together the Nicene Creed, found on page 358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
I invite you to join in today's prayers of the people, which is found in your bulletin. Our God, the Almighty One, counts the hairs of our head. Let us come before God in confidence, praying for the world, saying, hear our prayer. We thank you this day for the value you have placed upon us by giving us Christ our Savior. Empower us to acknowledge this gift in lives of service. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, God in Christ, that you have answered our fears with love. Give to us the faith to go where others dare not, to proclaim the vastness of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, God in Christ Jesus, that you are concerned with the frailty of our living. You know our addictions, our divorcings, our doubtings, and our escapes. Grant us the wholeness we seek, Lord, in your mercy. We thank you, God in Christ Jesus, that you aid those who work for justice and peace by giving them courage, vision, and strength. Enlist all people in the struggle for human dignity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, O God, that you favor the poor, the meek, the oppressed, the homeless, and the hungry. Make your compassion contagious, that the rich might share with the poor, the strong befriend the weak. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, O God, that you know the dangers that lurk among us. We pray for those whom you have called to guard and protect your entire creation, those who work the land, those who police the streets, and those who defend the nations. Strengthen them for their difficult tasks. Lord, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We thank you, O God, that you refresh us with times of leisure and recreation. Renew us that we might further appreciate you, each other, and all that you have made. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
At this time, we pray with special intention for Catherine, our presiding bishop, for Leo, our own bishop. We lift up to Christ Bishop Mary Gray Reeves and her family, the community of nuns and the convent of St. Helena's. We lift up to Christ all members of the Bishop Coadjutor Search Committee and all candidates for our next bishop. We pray also for the Anglican Church in Nigeria, for St. Joseph's Church in Eleuthera, for the Diocese of Antananarivo in Madagascar, our companion diocese. I invite you at this time to add to Christ your own prayers, your own petitions, your own thanksgiving.
Ask your prayers this morning as we mark the 50th anniversary of the killing of the three workers in Mississippi. Ask your prayers for peace in the Middle East, for compromise. We thank you, God, in Christ Jesus, that you are always more willing to listen than we are to pray. Hear the petitions of this assembled, gathered here this morning. Hear the prayers spoken in our hearts. For we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit keep you in eternal life. My brothers and sisters, may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
morning. Welcome to St. Mary Magdalene Episcopal Church. If you're a guest or a visitor, we would love to get the opportunity to get to know you better. Do we have any guests or visitors who wouldn't mind introducing themselves? And yes. That's okay, but let a regular, that's good. It's great to have you with us. God bless you, thank you. Welcome, good to have you back with us again. Anyone else? Well, it's great to welcome all of you back. I am so sorry that you had a tough time going up and coming back, but I hope the time there was good. You had a good time when you were there? Good, very good, excellent. Everyone's back from Canoga safely, and it's wonderful to have you back and filling these pews again. It's great. I know that we've got a couple of things going on. Is Perry here? Because I know that Perry wanted to talk to us about the barbecue. We have a 5th of July barbecue that we have planned, and we are going to do it on Saturday, July 5th, and it will take place at 5 o'clock. Go right ahead. Fire away. No, you've got the mic. Go right ahead. We're going to have fun. We figured last
night. Sure, we'll have fun.
As we're sitting here, we're going to watch the smoke rising up, very Anglo-Catholic.
It's going to be smoked ribs. We're sunny. Sunny and Tony. There he is, Sunny. Tony, I know Tony's here. I've got some great chefs that know what they're doing. Chicken, hot dogs, and hamburgers for the kids. We're going to have music. It's going to be...
Ribs.
Didn't I say ribs?
Yeah.
What did I say?
You're all right. Ribs.
Ribs. Ribs. There's going to be lots of ribs. $15 for adults, $10 for children, 12 and under, which is hot dogs and hamburgers. It's going to be a great time. It's the 5th of July, which is Saturday, so you'll do your fireworks and everything on Friday night, 4 o'clock to 9 o'clock. So it's a nice long party. Everyone is invited. By invited, I mean you have to buy a ticket. But please come. It'll be a great event. And of course, like everything, it's a little fundraiser for the church. So 5th of July, that's 2 weeks.
Sorry, 2 weeks.
So buy your tickets, please, today. Next week, the latest. We do need to get a count so that we know exactly how many ribs to make. It'll be a great event.
Typical in St. Mary Magdalene fashion, we wait until the last minute to get tickets. We do need a count. So if we could just get some tickets sold, that would be great. So I know that Perry's going to hand some of these off and we'll get these sold.
I've been asked to repeat the price. $15 for adults. That's for...
One five.
No, not 50. You're allowed to pay us 50. That's okay. We'll take 50. We're only asking for 50. That does not include beverages. And $10 for the hot dog hamburger for children, 12 and under.
Perfect. Thank you.
Did I pick this? The Brotherhood is not allowed to sell alcohol. We don't have a license to sell alcohol. There most likely will be some enjoyable refreshment there that we will allow you to make a donation for. Did I pass all the legal mustard on that one?
There will be alternatives also. All right.
Thank you.
That's great. Aaron, you want to come up here and talk to us? Tell us about how the week went. I know that it was going up and coming back, the traveling part was not so good. But that's when you leave the state of Florida, you know, you take it in your own hands.
Am I on?
Yes, I am.
All right. Well, first, I'm going to ask everybody here that you're going to have to file in this way. So come on up. Come on up. You can do it, Chels. I believe in you. Come on. We did. We left on Sunday, 3 o'clock in the morning, and we spent, our bus overheated, and we spent 5 hours in a gas station somewhere south of Columbia, South Carolina. But the good news was we weren't on the side of the road, and our bus drivers were really kind enough to get us to a gas station with a Subway, so everybody was fed, cool, and everything like that.
Oh, my gosh, we're having Subways for lunch today.
There's no way I'm ever looking at a Subway for a really long time. But yes, while we were there, the kids had an incredible time, and I want, just before we even start or go one step further, we have to acknowledge Christine Frist, please stand up. Brave chaperone she is. Please give her a round of applause. Christine and I attended a conference called Adults Who Work With Youth, and every year I'm always shocked at what fresh and innovative things they come up with, and this year our theme was going deep. And ironically, our youth group does go pretty deep. These kids know a lot about the Bible. And I'm really impressed that we were ahead of the curve a little bit this year. I was really encouraged, and it was a great opportunity, especially for Christine and I, who have kids of middle school age now. It's shocking to me. But I'm going to let the kids do the talking today. And they are going to tell you one thing that they enjoyed most about Canoga, and to thank you for all of your support.
I'm Chelsea. And my favorite part about Canoga was the opportunity to live with myself.
Hi, I'm Derica, and my favorite part of Canoga was learning the different songs and going on the rowboat.
Hello, I'm Jonathan, and my favorite part about Canoga was the music.
Hi, my name is Katie. My favorite part of Canoga was being able to meet some last year's participant. Nice to meet so many out-of-state people.
Hi, I'm Sydney, and my favorite part of Canoga was becoming closer to God.
Hi, I'm Kira, and my favorite part about Canoga is learning about the Holy Trinity.
Hi, I'm Rebecca, and also my favorite part about Canoga was learning about the Holy Trinity.
Hi, I'm Hannah, and my favorite part of Canoga was the activities that they had, which helped us learn about the Trinity.
Hi, I'm Chad, and my favorite part about Canoga was the activities, the music, and meeting people.
Hi, I'm Daniel. My favorite part about Canoga was the leap.
Hi, I'm Jack, and my favorite part about Canoga was all the worship and learning about God.
Hi, I'm Connor. My favorite part about Canoga was getting closer to God.
Hi, I'm Dorian, and my favorite part of Canoga is probably the music and the bacon.
Hi, I'm Aiden, and my favorite part of Canoga was the end party.
Great. We applaud your participation. We hope that you had a good time. It's great to have you back with us. Now, one thing that we need to do before, while you all are, I guess, seated. Most of you know that Aaron has been the youth director here for 12 years. And Aaron is getting ready to retire from youth ministry, take a break from for a little bit. And before we did that, wanted everyone to know that we have an ice cream social where we will be back in the parish hall right after the service. We all will get an opportunity to thank you for all of your hard work. And I want to thank you for everything that you've done in this parish and all the love and support that you've shown for all the youth in this parish and those who have moved on to college and started families of their own. You have done a wonderful job. God bless you.
Much. I want to thank our clergy, most importantly, for giving me this opportunity. Sue Glazia, who is not here, for recognizing a gift in 2 25-year-old kids that saw something special in us that we didn't even see in ourselves. So for Dave and I are forever grateful. And also I want to thank my husband for the infinite amount of biblical knowledge that he's fed me with to do all of our lessons, and without which is my parents, my mom and dad. Thank you for bringing me here and allowing me to be part of this community. The last thing I want first chat, you know this. The only thing I want these kids to know, upon my departure, the only thing I want them to ever remember about me, they don't even remember what I look like, is they're standing at the gates of heaven and somebody says to them, why do I need to let you in? What are you going to do, Chad? Who are you pointing at? Jesus. That's all I want them to know. So, and that's all I want anyone to know. You remember nothing. That's it. Thank you so, so much.
Thank you. When you started your ministry, there was no Facebook, no texting. Can you imagine? All that has changed so much.
We hope that all of you will join us for an ice cream social for not only the youth, but the conclusion of our Sunday school program for the while we take a summer break. So come back with us and share some time and some memories with you right after the service. Is there anyone celebrating a birthday, a wedding anniversary, or traveling? We invite you to come forward for a blessing. Birthdays, wedding anniversaries, and travel. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up as they fall. And in their hearts, mend the peace which passes all understanding. Abide them all the days of their life. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. We bless you also on your birthday. How old will you be? 12? 11? 13? Happy birthday. God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, wisdom, and true godliness, that the home may continue to be a haven of blessing and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Didn't like the sermon, is that? Oh God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation, in his presence we find wherever we go. Preserve those who travel, surround them with your loving care, protect them from every danger, and bring them in safety to their end through Jesus Christ our Lord. Love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God.
Should I feel this current?
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks.
It is right. And a good and joyful thing always and everywhere. Give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven. Forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit. Be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament. At the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him. The unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Hallelujah, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith.
accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace. Grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. When our late Christian visitor, please come forward.
Let us send her out together as she goes to visit those who are ill. In the name of this congregation,
we send you forth bearing these holy gifts, that those to whom you go may share with us in the communion of Christ's body and blood.
We who are many are one body, because
we all share one bread,
one cup.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you. Our closing hymn can be found in the Gather Hymn. It is hymn 533, They'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love.
Hallelujah.